Hi students, namaste. This is Arjun Gupta from St. Joseph Degree College. In this session, we are supposed to discuss regarding to internet banking. Internet banking is also called as online banking. To access a financial institution's online banking facility, a customer with internet access would need to register with the instructions for the service and set up a password and other credentials for customer verification. The credentials for online banking are normally not the same as for telephone or mobile banking. Financial institutions now routinely allocate customer number, whether or not customers have indicated an intention to access their online banking facility. The customer visits the financial institution's secure website and enters the online banking facility using the customer number and credentials previously set up. The type of financial transactions which a customer may transact through online banking usually includes obtaining account balances, list of the latest transactions, electronic bill payments, and funds transfer between a customer's or another accounts. Most banks also enable a customer to download copies of bank statements which can be printed at the customer premises. Some banks also enable customers to download transactions directly into customers' accounting software. The facility may also enable the customer to order checkbooks, statements, report loss of credit cards, stop payment on a check, advise changes of address, and other routine action. Now, let us see the development of e-banking in India. The increased usage of internet banking has affected the traditional banking system in India, that is branch-based banking, as for the first time in the last 13 years. Branch banking has reduced by a 15 percentage points during the same period. To sustain in the growing competition, commercial banks in India have adopted several initiatives to improve banking services and to gain competitive advantage. In this scenario, Indian banks have taken some of initiatives like Bank of India recently launched its cordless cash withdrawal service. This facility helps customers to send money to anyone using internet banking or using ATM with the help of receiver's mobile number. The business transformation program is being implemented by the Bank of Baroda, which will provide its customer convenience banking on a 24/7 basis in India and abroad with integrated delivery channels like internet, phone, mobile, and others. A number of Indian banks have implemented online tax accounting system for collection of taxes on behalf of Central Board of Direct Taxes, Government of India. ICICI Bank launched 24/7 electronic branch, which is a one-stop shop for all banking transactions. It offers facilities such as check deposit machine and an electronic kiosk through which customers can be accessed internet banking services. ICICI Bank has also introduced e-locker for its customers. It is a virtual locker which can be accessed through ICICI internet banking, which facilitates customers to store soft copy of their important documents safely, such as legal documents, agreements, policies, and various important certificates. ICICI Bank is offering various gifts to customers for starting to use internet banking for the first time. The banks are making their presence felt on social media like Facebook and Twitter for targeting huge customer base as well as potential customers. There will be round-the-clock tweets and comments on the bank's products and services after launching accounts on Facebook and Twitter. Now, let us see the common features in internet banking. Viewing account balance and recent transactions. Downloading bank statements. Paying third parties including bill payments and fund transfer. Investment purchase or sale. loan applications, transactions such as repayments of enrollments, and finally transaction approval process. These are the most common features that we can see in internet banking. Internet banking offers different online services in India. According to a report published by RBI, there are three different levels of banking services offered through internet banking. The first level was basic level services, the next level was simple transaction websites, and the third and final level fully transaction websites. Let us see one by one. First level, basic level services. It is a basically about websites which disseminate information about different services and products offered by banks. It generally includes receiving and replying to customer queries through email. Second one, simple transaction websites. It allows customers to submit their instructions and applications for different services, queries about their account balances, etc., but do not allow any fund-based transactions on their accounts. And finally, third level, fully transaction websites. It allows customers to manage their accounts, facility of fund transfer, bill payments, ticket booking, avail facility of other banking products and services, and trading in securities, etc. Now, let us see the challenges related to internet banking that prevail in Indian context. First one, security risk. The problem related to the security has become one of the major concerns for banks. A large group of customers refuse to opt for internet banking facilities due to uncertainty and security concerns. And second one, privacy risk. The risk of disclosing private information and fear of identity theft is one of the major factors that inhibits the consumers while opting for internet banking services. Most of the consumers believe that using online banking services would make them vulnerable to identity theft. Next, the trust factor. Trust is the biggest hurdle to online banking for the most of the customers. Conventional banking is preferred by the customers because of lack of trust on the online security. They have a perception that online transaction is risky, due to which frauds can take place. Next, customer awareness. Awareness among customers about the e-banking facilities and procedures is still at lower side in Indian scenario. Banks are not able to disseminate proper information about the use, benefits and facility of internet banking. Less awareness of new technologies and their benefits is among one of the most ranked barriers in the developing of internet banking. Finally, less internet penetration in Indian context. The internet banking channel has evolved over the years. In 2011, 60% of time basic transactions in banks were conducted in North America through online channels, whereas internet banking usage in India increased from 1% in 2006 to 7% in 2011. So, the knowledge and availability of internet is still one of the biggest challenges that prevail in Indian context. Students, this is regarding to the internet banking, and I hope you have enjoyed the session a lot, and thanks for watching the video. Thank you.